Very good morning all. In the previous lecture we were discussed about two stage network and baseline networks, what are their advantage and disadvantages. In this lecture we will talk about three stage network, but before coming upon three stage network I would like to recall the drawback or the disadvantages of two stage network. So these are the disadvantages of two stage network. Let's see what are disadvantages of two stage network. So these are the disadvantage. Disadvantages of what are these? A two-stage non-blocking network requires twice the number of switching elements as the single stage on non-blocking, and we calculated, we showed that this number of switching elements required in the two-stage network is 2n square, of course, which were more as compared to the single stage network. Okay, so the conclusion was two-stage network offer no distinct advantages over a single stage network except that it provides an alternative path for establishing a path. So we concluded that two stage network does not offer any distinct advantage over the single stage except that they provide an alternative path to establish the connection, okay, or the path. So to remove that drawback or limitations, we move on to the three-stage network. And what is three-stage network? The blocking probability and the number of switching elements can be reduced significantly by three-stage network. Okay, the blocking probability which we face in the second stage and first stage network and the number of switching elements can be reduced significantly by three-stage network. Okay, so how we reduce? Let's see. Three-stage network. The network is realized by using a switching matrix of following size. So in place of two-stage, in three-stage network, we use three stages of matrices. First stages consist PS switching matrices. Okay, so it consists first stage like this one, though I have explained. This is the first stage, this is second stage, and this is the third stage. Okay, so in the first stage we use the what we do, we use the PS matrices. Second stage we use the RR, and the third stage we use the SP switching matrix. And N is, that is, we are assuming again M is equal to N. Okay, M is equal to N. Fine. That is baseline network. So N is equal to PR. PR. In compared to this is the three-stage switching network. Here what we are doing, this is the first stage, we are using PS switching matrix. In the second stage we are using R by switching matrices, and in the third stage we are using S by P switching matrix. So this is the N, and this is also N, but why this is so? Because M is equal to N. Okay, and P, that is number of inlets and number of outlets, because we consider M is equal to N. Okay, then these are the R blocks in the first stage, they are the S block in the second stage, and these again R blocks, because we are assuming that first stage and second stage we are going to use the square switching matrix. So let me explain. In compared to two-stage network, there are S alternatives path between a pair of inlets and outlets. So in place of K, we are using as alternative path between a pair of inlets and outlets. So total number of switching elements become how much? RPS. RPS, that is this is the diagram. RPS means this is PS switching and R block. So RPS. The second stage, we are using how many switching elements? This is R into RR into S. Okay, and this is SP is equal to R. So we are using this one. We are using switching, total switching element RPS, SR square, SPR square. So if we calculate it, then it will become 2 RPS. Okay, then 2 RPS, and then this is 2, and you can see that is RP is equal to N is equal to RP. So we can replace RP is equal to N, and this is S and 2NS. Okay, so after simplification we have 2NS plus SR square. SR square is this. Taking the common S common, we have the S2NR square. This is the total number of switching elements. These are the total number of switching elements which we are going to use. Okay, then further we move on. This, if a square matrix is used in the first and the third stage, because first stage and third stage are having the same switching matrix. Okay, so we can use the switching matrix, that is P is equal to S, P square is equal to S square, that is equal to N. Okay, right. So this is P is equal to S is equal to under root N, square matrix bana aapka. If square matrix is in the first and second stage, we have PS is equal to NR. Why this is? Because we are using N is equal to PR and PS is equal to S. So we are having PS is equal to N upper R. Therefore, use the square matrix. Okay. Two N square. Okay, so when we replace that we have, when putting these all values into this one, we have equation number this one. By putting N is equal to PR and P is equal to S. Okay, so we are having 2N square upon R plus NR, and we are just naming as equation number 1. The above equation indicates that there is an optimum value for that would minimize the value of S. So there is this equations we can see that is the value of R will optimize the parameter S, which is the switching, total switching number. So R will be optimized. Optimized means that is one is R is also in denominator and also is the numerator. So R, the value of R should be optimized, that it should be optimum, so that we can have the minimum value of S. S is the switching element. So what we will do to minimize the value of S, we differentiate this equation, okay, with respect to R. So after differentiation, we are having this one. And after calculation, the value of r we find r is equal to under root 2n. This is very important. R is equal to under root 2n. So by putting this value into this equation, that is into this equation or in this equation, then we will have minimized value of s. The second derivative being positive at this value of r indicate that the value of s is minimum. Okay, so if we take the second derivative, then it will indicate that the value of s is minimum. Putting a value r is equal to under root 2n in the equation 1. So this is the equation s is equal to 2n square upon n plus nr. This is the s is equal to 2n square. This is the equation number 1. R plus nr square. Okay, so this is the equation number 1. If we put the value of r into this one, then after calculation we are going to have we named as the s minimum, because value of r will be optimized the value of switching elements. So after calculations we are having 2n under root 2n. This is the total number of or minimized number of switching elements in three stage. N value of p is equal to n by r, and by just having the, that is p is equal to n upon under root 2n. Okay, so this is the equation. After calculation we are having this. ये कैलकुलेशन आप कर लेंगे, मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन है, बहुत छोटी छोटी इक्वेशन है, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिटेल्स. ओके फाइन, हो जाएगा. सो व्हेन वी विल कैंसिल दिस वन, देन इट विल प्रोवाइड द अंडर रूट एंड अंडर रूट टू विच लीड द इक्वेशन, दैट इज एन बाई टू. Okay, there are, so this was the this was three stage. Of course you can see they are providing minimum number of switching elements, because in the first stage and the second stage we are having n square, that is a number of inlets gets squared. Okay, but here we are having only twice. And twice, which is of course less than square. So guys, it was all about the switching elements. So sorry, three stage network. And thus we have end up the first stage and second stage network and three stage network. There are a little bit things to understand. I mean, you have to focus because most video on YouTube and Google's, they are not very clear. So I try to make it very clear what are the first stage network. Already we have discussed in crossbar switching, then second stage network we started from here, then we analyze different condition of two stage networks, and we found that two stage network does not provide any advantage over first stage network. Only they provide the an alternative path. And then we just gone through three stage network of course provide minimize switching elements, of course, which will reduce the complexity of the circuit and cost of the circuit, space of the circuit. Okay, and very important, because we are using square switching matrix, which is available in the form of ICs. Okay, so guys, it was all about the three stage network. Rest, if you are not getting anything, please let me know. And And if you're not getting, let me know. And if you want to give any suggestion or anything which can improve my lectures, if you want that they are not at par, then please let me know. Okay. Then it's fine. Take care.